Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about page based routing. So consider that these are the pages, right? So whatever we create, like if you create about.js, it will become Next.js route. This we have already discussed. Like you put the same content in the about, it will start coming up in the about route of the page. Okay, so how can we create dynamic routings? Like you have some simple page like blogs, right? And then like consider that you are displaying lot of blogs here in the blogs.js. Okay, there are a lot of blogs you are showing, and what you are doing is you are just importing one particular class. Okay, and now you wanted to create a links of each and every blog. It can be as simple as this, right? So here we are trying to look for a single blog having this ID, right? So what we can do for these particular cases is we can just create a particular folder. Okay, what we can do is this blog and this ID, right? So there will be some dynamic ID we are just passing. So what we can do is we can just create blog folder. Inside that we can create id.js with these square brackets. So with the help of this, it will be able to handle all the tasks, all the routes which are coming with blog forward slash dynamic id. I will just remove this content and will say okay, not even class name, I'm just trying to use it. Child component. Child component as a blog. So you might be getting this ID from the React from the next router. Okay. So this is like how we are doing a dynamic path. In this now you can actually use the router. You can use a router and you can actually query this. Const router equal to use router, we don't have, so we just need to import it. Use router from next router. Okay, so here we can import use router, and then you can actually get this data from the router query. So what I can do is router.query.id. Okay, this is how you can print it. You can actually do the null check. If id is not coming, then what need to be done? But this is how you can access the query parameter and all the routes which are coming with blog forward slash one will be handled by this blog forward slash abc. Anything at one level down will be handled by this particular id.js. Similarly, if you want a wildcard, means all the nested routes should also be handled. So what you can do is instead of doing this, we just put a dot dot dot. In this particular case, either you put all these particular routes will be handled by this blog page itself. Okay, and how you will get? You will get these attributes in the page itself. So this is how actually the routing works. These are called page based routing. Okay, and you can actually manage it just by providing the path in your particular page, like dash 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 dot 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 id, right? So in this particular case, it should be able to handle all different kind of requests which are coming. So in this router.query, it is coming as an object. So in this particular case, router.query will contain an object. So it is an ID, and whatever you are adding in the routes like ABCD, that will come as argument. Here it will be A. That will be a array of IDs. If we are talking about this particular example, where this particular route is able to handle this particular request. Okay, if you are not putting triple dot means id.js, then it should be able to handle only this particular case, and you are getting everything in the router.query. Okay, even if you do foo equal to bar, in this particular case this router.query will contain all these in the object. So router.query will contain id is a, and then there is a foo whose value is bar. This is foo and value of this is bar. This is how this router query is working, and we are actually using use router to extract the query parameters. Okay, so if you are getting this is an array, like you can just do const IDs equal to router dot query dot ID. If it is there, you can just do a join on this router dot query dot ID dot join, and we can just print these IDs. It will be now a string, right? So this is called path based routing, which is decided based on the path which you have entered. Now here similarly you can have a contact, and inside contact particular contact id.js, something like this. And in Next.js this also provides the API based routing when you do npm run dev. Okay, this is API based routing, and these all APIs are exposed on /API. Let me add comment. So API, so /API, so this particular is actually REST API you have created, which is nothing but it is going to render this particular JSON object once server is coming up. Okay, so in future examples we will talk about what is this underscore app, underscore document, and underscore error. These are like some predefined, but you can also override app, document, and error pages for your Next.js application. This is path based routing. Now router has lot of different methods, router.push, router.prefetch. Okay, here we are using use router with router. There are many ways of accessing the router data. Currently we are using use router. There is also a concept of export default function with router. It will actually convert your functional component into higher order component. Export default with router home. So here you can create this variable, and from here it will expose as the props. In the props dot query, props dot query, you will be able to access the query parameter. Okay, so that's it guys. Thanks everyone.